Hello and welcome everybody to part one of my Sparta Let's Play for Total War Rome 2. Fresh off the bat from some multiplayer battles and my Rome Let's Play earlier this morning, I'm now launching into my Spartan Let's Play, so I'm hoping I've gained a little bit of knowledge since then. You guys have been telling me lots of tips that you guys have found out so far, and I have found out that naval battles are definitely not my thing in multiplayer, and that generally I'm quite overwhelmed in multiplayer by the just sheer selection of units and which ones to use. So if at any point you feel you've got any good builds that you want to share with me for multiplayer, feel free to send them in an email or PM to me, because I'll be happy to try them out. Because if I'm honest, I definitely suck at Rome 2's multiplayer. Notably because it's a mainly melee-based game, whereas I'm probably a lot better at Empire and Napoleon, I'd like to think. Anyway, this is Sparta. Yeah, someone had to say it. So playing hard difficulty. Apparently the initial challenge is hard on this, so we'll see if I die straight away. They've got Spartan Knight Warriors, plus one experience rank for Spartan infantry units, or recruits rather, Laconic Austerity, minus 10% wealth from industrial and commerce buildings, and Heliot Repression, minus 25% servile unrest. So we begin. And I'm playing for military victory conditions again, so it's 140 readings I've got to take. And about, I think it's 180 units I've got to command. After these first sort of three Let's Plays I'm doing, I've got one more to record after this, Iceni. And then I've got the first parts of all three up today. After I complete all these three factions, I'll be looking at perhaps trying out a different victory condition styled game. Or I may even do that in the co-ops that I'm planning at the moment, so we shall see. But, here we go with Sparta.
The people of Epirus are fools. Having utterly failed to conquer Rome, they crawl back and presume to conquer Greece. To try is not to win. They will know this when you meet them in battle. Macedon may join you, but they are no better in the end. Alexander's conquests have left them with delusions of grandeur. They will be checked, as will every other aggressor. You may fare better working with Athens and other true Greek states, but history has often taught otherwise. Ultimately, trust only in Sparta, and you will prevail.
Wise words there, and we've got our kind of first objective. From humble beginnings come great things. Take your first step and establish a foothold from which to launch your people to greatness. Objectives: completely control two provinces, either by direct ownership or through client states and military alliances. Pretty standard. We get a decent amount of income reward. Decent income to start with. You know what? As much as I enjoy the Rome Let's Play to start with, and I think I've always found this, the reason why I'm quite happy with Sparta or any of the Greek states, whichever one got it, obviously Sparta took the lead very early on. I like these small factions that start off with one region and then you have to build out. Yes, it's a more instant challenge, but I really do like, you know, you don't, especially with a new game as well, you know, I can learn the basics and I can see all the stuff. I mean, there's maybe, I don't know, let me know what you think in the comments. Do you find, from what you've played so far of Rome, that it seems more complex, or do you just find that the arrangement of the UI and the menus makes it seem more complex? Because all of these things down the left-hand side that show up when I hover over a building, to me, I'm looking through it and going, okay, wow, there's quite a lot of information there. I think it's they've merged quite a few different panels all into one, so, that is good. But, what do you guys feel? So, anyway, we can build either a farm, which is 6 food, 40 wealth, and 2% unit replenishment, or we can go for herding ground, which is 4 food and 80 wealth from livestock. I'd kind of like to go, I think the farm's a better option there. So I'm going to put in a farm. We've got to capture, obviously, Athens. This settlement over here. To take control of all of Helios. Fair enough. So also in that description, you're saying Macedon, the pronunciation for Macedon, or so I assume Macedon, the traditional Greek pronunciation Commander. Of it. So Macedon has obviously come along with it because of the more phonetic spelling, I guess. So if I say Macedon. Which is right, I guess, or are both right? Is it, should it be Macedon, or is Macedon fine? You know, just out of interest. Anyway, I'm going to move my spy up here. See if we can sabotage anything. I'm actually going to... I could risk poisoning the wells. You know what, I'm going to risk it. Even if I lose my spy straight away, I'm going to risk it. Because I didn't do that with my Rome Let's Play, and I want to take a bit more. Sabotage failed, but they didn't die. Okay, that's cool. I'm glad. I don't know if they do have a chance of dying straight away, so... Anyway, so let's take a look at a family here. So what do we got? Royal family, and then other families. So royal family controls a lot of, you know, the power. Defensive allies. We've got Macedon as a defensive ally. And then we're at war with Epirus. Can't say that even though it just said it in the thing. Epirus. Help me out there, guys. This is uber fail already. And we've got trade partners with Athens. So, okay, let's take a look at technology first. Logistics, worth getting first. Trade and finance. Everyone is... Well, we've just got Sparta right now, so everyone's kind of happy, which is good. And where are we gaining all that happiness from? Characters and military presence. What have we actually got? We've got Spartan hoplites and Heliot javelin men. And my general, who is Royal Spartans. And then we have another general up here. Who forms another one of my families. Or is, does he? That's my general. Ah, no, here's my other general here, I think. Looks like him. Because it doesn't actually say the general's name. It just says general. Oh, no, it says that. Fail. So, yeah, that's how... I'm kind of learning more about the whole family tree and how it's all integrated. So, this dude actually isn't a character on the map. But, you know, they can gain skills and things like that. So that you can promote them and things. So, I'm learning all that as I go. It's going to be very interesting to see how that works, kind of the meta game as such. So, anyway, we can hire mercenaries or something like that. We can get mercenary cavalry. There's a lot to actually... Here we can mercenary hoplites, and I was looking because I hired quite a few in my Rome Let's Play, and I didn't really look at the upkeep. And the upkeep cost is quite a lot, which is the downside to mercenaries. Because I was thinking actually these guys aren't that expensive to hire. Turns out upkeep is the same it seems as their recruitment in this case more though. So I don't want to go for any of them. We'll leave them out. We'll go for purebred Spartan units. So we've got pikemen here. I'm just looking at, I'm learning all the defences and stats as we go along, because, you know, as much as I'd love to, I want to get this content up to you guys today rather than, you know, I probably, in all best interest, should probably play the game a bit and then record, but I just want to throw myself in there, learn as I go, and hopefully you guys will be more than accommodating in the comments. So melee attack's 21 on that one, and... There's 21 here, but the weapon damage is more on these guys. Slingers, javelin men, but I assume pikemen, they can form their pike flanics, yeah. So good defensive unit, low damage, but average armor penetration, average attack, very vulnerable when not in phalanx. Or I said flanics, didn't I? Phalanx. Damn it. Fail. Okay, so I've got a hoplite phalanx, good defensive unit. I'm going to go for the... Yeah. I'm going to go for these hoplites.
Come, fight with us.
Get a few more of them, and then we'll get some javelin men in there when we can. Actually, no, I'll do it there. So, we're not at war with Athens yet. We actually have a trade agreement with them. But it kind of... I suppose it poses the dilemma. Do you take out Athens quickly? But we're going to cause a bit of trouble there. Or do I focus on taking out Epirus? Because to claim the province, I'm going to have to take out Athens. And would it be wise to take them out now and just get it done and over with? Or not? But I think I can't really afford to do that because they're a client state of Macedon. Or Macedon. That's going to cause a lot of problems. So for now, I think I really do need to leave Athens. And I'm going to have to, you know, go off to Knossos and take out Epirus as well. So, with Macedon, let us see about diplomacy.
Welcome. I throw open the doors to you and bid you enjoy our talks.
Good, good. We've got trade. It says break trade agreement with, but where is sign a trade agreement? Or can we not? Are we trading? It says we've got a defensive alliance, but I don't know if we're trading or not with them. Let's cancel that. Oh, we've got trade. Shows whether we're trading or not. Oh, we can't trade with them, that's why, because there's no sea route established. That would be why. So we're just at war with Ypres. Okay. And we're a defensive alliance with Macedon. So ready, that one's mustering. Battle. That army is mustering.
Ready for orders.
Got the Temple of Zeus or something. Never know. So we have my main general's army here, and he has the royal or phalanx, as does the second general.
Ready for battle.
So let's with him get some units as well. Are they worth getting the spear unit? Though they can form square. So we've got two javelin men here, and Spartan hoplites. Let's get more of these guys. And they're going to take two turns. But once we do, we should be fine. Spending a lot of money, I know, but I want to obviously launch multiple invasions. I want to send this guy out
ready
soon. And with these guys, I'm not going to go against Athens, or even though I just kind of committed or tried to commit an agent crime because I didn't look at them properly. So we're going to go towards Ypres, so we'll have to sail round. So that's all we need to do this turn, I think, so we can end the turn there. We will continue on. So yeah, I guess I should note, do go check out the first part of the Rome Let's Play, and the Iceni Let's Play will also be up after this one. So Rome's already up though, so go check that out. And I've got an hour and a half of online battle action that I engaged in via live stream earlier as well. War target available. Thanks to recent events, you can now suggest a target to your allies. Okay.
What do you wish of me?
Athens is sending an army towards Ypres. In a way, it would be kind of useful if Athens got taken out by Ypres. But I kind of want to get here soon, don't I? Sabotage, so we can... Let's try risk poisoning the wells here. Opportune failure. Not entirely wasted. They have learned more from the failure than they would otherwise have done. And they've increased in rank, so it's beneficial for them anyway, and they haven't died in it. I don't know if agents can die by failing actions now. Cunning, authority, or campaign map range. I'd like to go for let's go for agent. It's got the plus authority and critical chance of it succeeding. So now with this large army,
orders.
I don't have the permission to move through here, I don't think. So I'd need to make military access with them. So let's see if we can do that. I want to do this right with Athens. They're very friendly with us. So let's
see. I give you welcome. Let Zeus and all the gods.
A non-aggression pact. Let's go for military access.
Military access is a symbol of trust between two factions, allowing troops to move about and replenish in one another's territory without diplomatic penalties.
They're offering a counter-offer. Their demand's 150 and they'll join the war against Ypres. We'll accept that offer. We'll pay that for them to join in, keep them busy, but I would like that military access. Okay, military access, and I'll add a payment in there. Odd numbers, but we'll offer that much. They've accepted, okay. I want to do this right moving through their lands. So we've got military access, so we can move through there fine. Faction joins war. Athens versus Ypres, which is good. So I'm going to bring my Spartan force round to form up with them.
Is that all?
Force march. I want to read all these different stances. Plus 100% campaign map movement range. Minus 25 morale for all units, so you can really, if you need to get them somewhere quickly, that does help. And minus 50% chance of anticipating an enemy ambush. Okay. All the other ones are once you're in an enemy territory, I believe. And that's raiding. So minus 20% upkeep for all units. Plus 5 morale. Minus 10% public order. Minus 5% growth from raiding. Incurs diplomatic penalties with the raided factions. And then the next one is an ambush. I wonder if I can go up then and choose the ambush one. So, okay, I can't use that one for whatever reason, so I'm going to pull back. Maybe I need to research it or something. I'm going to form up near the Athenian army.
Ready for wait battle. There.
So we're recruiting these guys now. We're going to wait a little bit longer there. Oh, I don't want to recruit mercenaries. What am I on here for? Let's go to my trade and finance. I just want to check that everything's coming in fine here. Total expenditure and all the income. Other, I assume that's King's Purse. Base income. Okay, fair. Okay. Cool. I think we can end the turn there. We've got another turn for technology and it's done. And as I showed in my Rome part, it's actually quite nice that the game actually notifies you if you've kind of forgotten to do, you know, set some technology to... Oh, agent tried to assassinate me. But yes, it does. Ooh, okay. Attack me. And they've got elephants. No. I am going to withdraw for now.
Disengage!
I don't want to risk that. I'd rather...
At ease, men.
I didn't like it with the fact they had those reinforcements. They have the reinforcement now pulled back. What was I saying? Oh yeah, the game reminds you if you haven't set a technology to research before when you hit the end turn button. It'll say, you haven't set one, do you want to set one or do you want to continue? Which I think is quite a good thing, because often you forget about research and then that can quite badly screw you over. Assassination attempt, but it's failed. Logistics has been researched. That's been done, so let's get into organised supply, because then we can get marine training, military settlement as well. Commander. Right, so... came out and they attacked me. Ah, I can set an ambush once. I think I've got to wait in an area for a turn. Pull my agent back and see if we can find where that army's gone. I don't know where it has gone, which I don't like the look of. Can I be of no assistance? I would say one thing that I think maybe could be improved a little bit. The colouring of where your units can move isn't sometimes that easy to spot because the colour kind of blends a little bit towards the terrain. I would think. You know, so far just playing, just kind of pointing out a few things. That's my only major gripe, is that it's sometimes not always as easy as you think to spot an enemy force. Okay, so I'm going to form up near this army here. I want to stay close to them if we're going to be attacked. Right, Ares Dread, that's the name of the legion. And the Herak. Glycide? Ah, I can't say that. Someone tell me how to say this legion's name. It's an awesome legion. Crit units, anyone else? We've got plenty of... I'm going to try leading a naval invasion of the settlement. Well, I'm kind of tempted to recruit a few more troops. It surely can't hurt having more troops. So we'll spend another turn recruiting more troops, building up a force. I don't really want to pay all that for the mercenaries. But maybe some citizen cavalry, are they any good? Attack? Melee? Let's compare them to the attack of these guys. They've got the same amount of attack bar. My hoplites here. My royal Spartans. We'll leave it for now. And with that done, I probably should be building stuff in Sparta, which I've forgotten about. So what's the difference here? Heliot archers or pelsters, and from here we can Sisson cavalry and Spartan hoplite. That's what I really want, so I need organized supply. I've got the farm and I can't build that for late till later on, so we'll leave that for now. End the turn then. That is the case here, but I want to get into a battle and have a look at these Spartans. Okay, so they went up and they taken out Larissa? I'm not quite sure. I'm being conservative, but we'll see how it goes. Early days. Also, I probably should note that if I do lose one of these campaigns very early on, I will sort of restart and try and and go again. Right. So these guys got pushed back. So they tried to attack at least. You can call on the road again. Assassination. Concealed blade, poison. Let's try and poison the general. Your agent's been wounded. Okay, so it looks like maybe you can't kill them, and it's just like agents in Napoleon's Total War, where you just wound them.
That's your command.
So here, I wonder if... What they got? Hoplites, and their general, which is the Royal Guard. Levy pikemen, slingers and javelin men.
Ready for battle! Besieging settlement!
Let's attack them, but let's encircle them and just keep it up for now.
Let them cower like cannel dogs.
They'll have to come and attack us.
For the gods!
Recruited all those extra troops here now, so with Spartan's force, I'm going to set sail. Or I may have just crashed the game. I think I've just... No, I haven't. Oop, just took a wild pause there. Okay. Okay, and the... Right, conditions are going down in Sparta. Taxes and slaves. Need organized supply ready soon, which will be done very shortly. That's not going to do anything for population. Ah, here we go. This will do it. This is population growth, research rate, wealth. Oh, I was hoping it would do some repression, but no, we'll put the money into that though. Start building that up. And with this force, Ares Dread, we're going to sail round to here. We're going to go over here and land on this beach. So we'll go over there. Right. Let's end the turn again. And we may well be attacked if Epirus sallies out. Epirus. Oh, God. It really annoys me that I cannot remember what it's called. And it's going to be blatantly obvious. Because someone's going to comment with the right pronunciation straight away. Oh, well. But as well in the comments, feel free to let me know what you guys think of the game so far. Because, to be honest, I don't know if it's come across in my commentary. I'm kind of feel a bit dazed. Because I'm very impressed by it. And I'm just trying to, you know, just absorb everything as I can. Your armory is suffering heavy losses maintaining the siege. Men lost. The enemy are doing all they can to fight off. Really? Oh, I get attrition. Surely, oh, they face attrition as well. So it's whether the attrition's greater or what. Oh, but now battle deployment is slightly in our favour. We've lost quite a few men in that. You know what? We're going to fight it and we're going to see if we can kill them, if we can win. We'll take the battle to them. We've whittled down quite some of their troops quite a bit, actually. Two of their units in particular, the Hoplites, and I think these guys are spearmen. Taking them down quite a bit. Loading up the Battle of Larissa. Various quotes came up in the middle. I do like this layout so you can see your units versus theirs on the loading screen. I think that's pretty cool. Okay, let's start the deployment. I'm happy with the terms of battle that we're fighting under, the weather. So, my two troops missile units. So let's have a look. This is Larissa. It's already been besieged for quite some time, and this is where we've got to capture this central area here with a column in the middle. So it's like the natural entry point here. I'm going to put my full force to bear on one side rather than splitting my forces up. I think that's probably better to go for. So, line of sight, obviously, in effect, so we can see them forming up over here. Let's have a look at my troops. My royal Spartans look pretty darn awesome.
And how the gods no longer love them. Prepare!
My general, I think. No longer have them on the edge of the unit, but right in the middle. So, let's march forward.
Ready for orders? At your service. General, understood.
And everyone's slowly walking forward, which is good. Javelin men looking pretty cool. Nice beards on everyone. Makes me miss my beard. General lifting up his sword, ready for battle and glory.
Missiles awaiting targets.
I'm waiting to see how long it's going to be before somebody makes a 300 parody with Rome 2 style sort of parody. I don't know what units you'd use. I guess the Royal Spartans are the closest thing you'll get. Perhaps. Well, there's the Heroes of Sparta unit as well, actually. Alright, let's see how they're deploying against us. We've got hoplites in front. Looks like they're charging forward with slingers.
Javelin men!
Okay, we're still out of range, but this is the entirety of their force as far as I can see.
The horses are usually in charge.
Our general is under attack.
Oh, we're being hit by their slingers. They're actually able to fire this far, so we need to push for forward.
Eriolkoi hoplites,
Spartans,
ready and waiting.
We'll go into phalanx. And then we can we can push forward. I'm going to hit these slingers with the javelin men. Move forward with my general's bodyguard, because actually I've taken quite a few losses. Apparently, but I'm looking for the... Oh no, the losses would have been from attrition. I was thinking, where are the dead bodies on the ground? There's a few of them here, but these are from these other units. So my javelin men are now engaging the slingers. See the damage it's doing quite a bit. I love how the javelins as well are getting stuck in the shields and things like that, and they get stuck in the guys. And they start, you know, putting their shields up to try and protect themselves. We've got the bars here. The green one is the unit's health, and the blue is the ammunition. These guys being utterly annihilated. All that dude just collapsing. Oh, got some really good impact physics, I think, in animations. I think they look pretty darn good. And we've nearly, with their wavering, should be broken shortly. I'm also bringing down these hoplites quite a bit. But then again, can't tell too much because of the attrition they've already taken. Let's focus on these hoplites now. Meanwhile, we're pushing forward with our guys in phalanx. Tight formation. My missile troops are now pulling back because they're in skirmish mode. And there we go. Hit them back. Pull close together so they can fight shoulder to shoulder. And they are pushed back. So we're going to remain in formation. All these guys want to form up strong, solid lines.
Commander, orders. Your orders.
Ready and waiting.
Your orders.
But we now need. They have more javelin men up here, which I want to try and bring down. Because they are already taking down quite a few of my guys. It's just fun watching them die a little bit.
Spear infantry, at your command.
Javelin men now hitting their javelin men as they fall back. my phalanxes, or well, the hoplites are charging in, but they've got pikemen. Pikemen are going to cause a bit of problem for my men. This unit, I want it to come back and hit the Royal Guard. I want to pull back with my hoplites because they're getting hit by those pikemen quite a bit, and I don't want to lose all my men there. I want to pull back and reform. Javelin men shaking now. Okay, that's one of my javelin men out. I'm back in there. Hoplite phalanx. Charging here against the pikemen. She obviously put away their large pikes. Not attacking smaller formation. Get my general to come forward along with my infantry now. Charging forward.
One of our units has used all its ammunition.
These guys can now come out of skirmish mode and just pull back. Royal Spartans getting in the mix there. Hitting the enemy Royal Guard as well. And we're waving both these units so we can now do a strike back on the enemy general and hit back. We're holding against these hoplites, and we can now smash back against the enemy general and claim victory. Cheer goes up. These guys are shattered. They're trying to pull out, and they're gonna be squashed in there.
The enemy general
is dead. We'll end the battle there. A decisive victory. Killed 683, and we lost 214. I can live with that. Put up a good fight. That was fun. There is a tendency I'm finding personally that you know, almost to forget about commentating, forget about commanding, just watching a unit. I think I probably need to just spectate a few games and just watch people play the game, because, or watch what you guys are doing right now, I guess, on YouTube watching this. But you know, I'm actually quite driven to just sit back and watch, because there's just so much going on, and just controlling all the units feels awesome. I just want to zoom in all the time and watch them kill each other. And I know it's probably going to be the end of me, or the end of my generals by doing that. So that was a fun battle. Lasted 7 minutes 36 seconds, they have a battle duration on there. Now, I do want to admit, some of these battles do seem quick, but then there's not too many units involved, and they're scrapping. You know, the AI there went in almost kind of... tried to kind of like a wave attack, you know, attacked with a few units, realised they weren't working, pulled them back, tried to reorganise. But obviously I had more men than they did, and I was able to use the phalanxes to, you know, really help out there. So, we can occupy, we can loot, or we can raise, and I'm going to occupy.
Is that all?
Increase in rank for Gallinus.
Ready for battle.
General details, and we're going to be a commander, strategist, or a warrior. I'm going to go for a strategist on him. So they're all replenishing now, which is good. We can recruit new units. And I'm going to go for more hoplites here. And I don't have the funds to build anything else, but they seem alright now. Where are they going to be? They're going to be minus 22. And why is that? Conquest for the next turn only, and then they should level out. So hopefully they should be fine. Ah, Epirus. We have an enemy fleet here, which is a raiding javelinman, whereas all my guys are on transport ships. So I don't really want to risk them up against them like that. So I'm actually going to put them back back on the shore, and we're going to march out like so over here. I'm not going to put them into the sea just yet. I really don't want to. We don't start with a fleet, Sparta, so there's no Spartan fleet to help defend ourselves against these raiders. We don't have a port. Athens does, it's the closest thing. So we're going to have to hold off. We've taken Larissa already, made good progress there, and we've researched supply reform, so we can go for marine training or military settlements. Let's have a look at these two briefly. Ah, dry dock and docks. So that would be what I would need. Let's go for marine training in that case. And now at Sparta, we can upgrade this next time when we have some more money. But anyway, that's where I'm going to wrap up this part for now, guys. I do hope you enjoyed. Please do check out the links to my other Let's Plays, which will be in the description. I hope you've enjoyed. Please do remember to comment, subscribe, and I will see you all again soon. Ciao for now.